The topic that we are going to start today is ecosystem. So the foremost question that comes to everyone's mind is, what is ecosystem? So ecosystem, this term called ecosystem was given for the first time by a British ecologist, Tensley. So Tensley was a person who did a lot of research about ecosystem, what is it, what are its types and all that. So he was the first one basically to give the terminology ecosystem. There can be different definitions and different things that we can imagine about ecosystem. But according to a functional unit, it is basically a functional unit in which an organism interacts with their environment and their mutual relationships can be identified and studied. So in a simple terms, if I say basically environment is a place where we interact with our environment. Environment can be your physical environment around you. It can be your air. It can be your land. It can be water. Anything around us is called environment. And it also talks about its relationship. Like what kind of relationships that we share with our environment. Whether we have a good relationship or what we are doing, we are protecting it, we are not protecting it. And environment, it's about the plants, the animals, anything and everything that comes under it. So if we talk about the types of ecosystem, mainly ecosystem can be divided in broadly two parts. One is your terrestrial ecosystem and the second one is your aquatic ecosystem. So terrestrial, as the name suggests, terrestrial means land. So here we are going to talk about the ecosystem which is there on the land, and aquatic, as the name says, it means water. So that means we are going to talk about the ecosystem that we have in the water. So now let's go one by one. So first we are going to talk about or discuss about the terrestrial ecosystem. You can see in the picture here we have different kinds of forests. We have some water here. So we have some animals. So ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem deals with all the things combined together. It can be your forest. It can be your land. It can be your climate. Everything. So further, terrestrial ecosystem can be divided in five different types, and further they are also subdivided. So we will be talking about it one by one in this lesson. So first of all is forest biomes. So first of all we are going to talk about the forest, what kind of forest types we have. Then the second is savanna. Now what is savanna? That also we will do it once we start up in detail. But to brief you about the savanna is a kind of a transition phase between the forest biomes and the grassland biomes. So if you see here, like it's not complete trees and not a complete grassland. So it is a combination of two. So it is a transit between these two phases. Then we have is grassland biomes. Mainly we have a lot of grasses here, like you can see that the animals or the pastures, they can go in for their feeding and all. Then we have is desert biomes. As we can see here that there are some sand or something like that. So we will be talking about the desert biomes here. And the last one we have is called tundra biomes. As the picture says, it is nearly about something, a kind of a cold weather or nearly to the polar sides. So we will talk about all of them one by one in the lesson. So first of all, in case of terrestrial biomes, the first was forest biomes. So we will be starting off with the forest biome. So forest biomes is mainly which deals with the forest area. Like what kind of forest areas do we have on our earth, on our environment? So forest biomes can further be of different types, like tropical rainforest or evergreen forest, we call them. Second will be the tropical deciduous or the monsoon forest, we will be talking about in detail. Needle leaf forest or boreal forest. montane forest that we will be talking about, and secluvial forest. So these are mainly the five types of forest biomes that we would be discussing about in the further slides. The first one we will be talking about, tropical rain forest. As the name says, rainforest. So I think something can come to your mind, like if it is a rainforest, or if the word rain comes, we know what is rain. So basically these forests have lot of rainfall actually, so that we will be talking about. First, let's see where do we find them. Mainly we find these forests at around the tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. I mean, if this is an equator, for example, if we talk about, so mainly they are found between the this region. So they are your tropical green forest, rainforest or evergreen forest. Mainly it is found in these countries like Brazil. Here we have Brazil here, somewhat like here in Latin America. Then we have is Hawaii. Hawaii Islands are here around here at this region. The Dominican Republic of the Congo, again we have here in Africa. Southern coast of Australia. So if you talk about Australia, here in the southern coast we have these forests. Thailand, Malaysia. So here we have Thailand and Malaysia here. Madagascar, Madagascar is about here, somewhat like here. Then New Zealand and Peru. New Zealand is here just next to Australia, and Peru is again one of the Latin American countries just next to Brazil. So these are mainly the countries where we find these tropical rainforest or evergreen forest. So what is a climate? I mean, what does it need to grow up? So it has a very short summers and a very long winter, rainy seasons. As the name was, tropical rainforest. So rainy season, it is a very long rainy season we have here. The when it is a rainy season, obviously there will be a lot of rainfall. So annual rainfall in this region is around 2000 to 2250 millimeters, which says around 78.75 inches to 88.58 inches. This is an average rainfall, annual rainfall in these tropical rainforests. The temperature here is neither too hot and not too cold. It is usually between 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. So it ranges, it varies from this temperature. The average humidity out here is very high. It's not a normal one, but it is a very high humidity here. It is between 77% to 88% in a normal average case. So if it is like this, so let's talk about the forest. What kind of forest do we have here, or what kind of trees, or what is the characteristics of the trees out here? So the trees here are about 60 to 30 feet tall, and they make a kind of a canopy. What is canopy? So if you see the picture here, so the trees are very tall, we can see here, and they form a canopy. Canopy is just like, you can say, a big umbrella which covers, you know, something like you would have seen many people selling the products, or if you go and buy the SIM cards, you find people sitting in a canopies, you know, out there to protect themselves from the shades or something. So these trees make a big canopies basically to protect, I mean, to let the sunlight get into. So the forest floor is mostly shaded, because as the trees make canopies here, if you see here, the forest floor here, they are mainly shaded because they are so thick, and so canopies are so thick that the sunlights cannot, you know, penetrate here. It cannot go down on the floor. So the forest floor is mostly shaded, and rarely with sunshine reaching the floor. So if you see here, we don't have any kind of sunshine, that's so dark here. The trees have long and smooth trunks. So as we said, the trees are very tall, so they have a long and very smooth trunk. So if you touch their trunks, they'll be very smooth. Trees here rarely shed their leaves. I mean, it is raining, they don't shed their leaves in any part of their year. And the mainly it is famous for lianas, that is woody climbers. So because on these woody climbers, basically we call them as vines also. Vines are basically those plants or those trees which take the support of some other trees and they grow. Like in our houses, we have money plant. So money plant is one example of the vine. There can be other, like, you know, we have grape vines and other vegetable vines. So here it is very famous for these kind of woody climbers in this region. Then what kind of animals, let's talk about. So these are the three main animals that are found, which are not found in any other part of the environment or any other type biome. So these are the kinkajous, the poison dart frogs, and the sloth. So mainly I'll tell you what are they. If you talk about this picture, this is kinkajous, and they are mainly found in the Central America and Amazon, you can say. These, if you look at them, they look very innocent, but mainly they are carnivorous animals, but they mainly eat fruits. They survive on fruits, but actually they are carnivorous animals. So if now you look at this picture, you see a blue color frog. This is known as the poison dart frog. And they are mainly found in Central America. And I can say that this eats mainly ants and termites, but to be very careful of them, it is one of the most poisonous frogs, or I can say the animal on the earth we have. It is so poisonous that even if you go and touch its body, it can kill human beings. So even human beings can get killed even though if you go and touch it. Its poison is so strong. The last here is a sloth. It looks like something like a koala or a bear, but it is one of the slowest mammal on the earth we have. I'll give you an example to talk about like how slow it is. To cover a distance of 1 kilometer, it takes at least 1 month. So you can imagine the speed of this sloth. It is herbivorous and it mainly eats fruits and leaves. So these are the animals that may be mainly found in the rainforest. Then we'll be talking about the plants. What kind of plants do we find? Mainly we have is rosewoods. We find rosewood here. We have rubber plants here. Cinchona is another plant that we find here. These are the some pictures of these plants that we have put on here. Apart from that, I mean, there are other plants also. And this kind of forest is also known as evergreen forest. Evergreen because the trees are green throughout the year. They don't shed their leaves. So that's why they are also called, these rainforests are also called evergreen forests. So the next type of forest that we are going to talk about is tropical deciduous forest or monsoon forest. So why they're called tropical deciduous or monsoon forest, that we will be talking about in the further slides.